This is one of the entrance gates to Indiana University. The view just past the gate. This is the student building. It's in the Romanesque Revival style. We're in a limestone gazebo. That is Herman B. Wells, Indiana University's 11th president and chancellor from 1962 to year 2000. This is Kirkwood Hall. You can see from the roofing that it has Second Empire elements. The year for this building is 1894. Myers Hall. Here we have an archway with Art Deco figures. These are on the other side of the arch. Built in 1954 in the collegiate Gothic style. Jordan Hall, and at the very top, a microscope. This is Memorial Hall. It was the first women's dormitory here on campus. It was built in 1925. There's a sundial clock up there. Here we are at the largest student union building under a single roof in the whole world. Indiana Memorial Union. Here's a continuation of the building. This is still the Memorial Union. No wonder it's the world's largest. This is a view of the lounge area, complete with a white piano. And a fireplace. This place is huge. School of Journalism. This is the Art Museum We've made our way inside. We've made it to the library. We're going in. This library is so huge, the East Tower has 11 floors, each the size of a football field. We've made it to a campus arboretum. Indiana University, football field. It's horseshoe shaped, just like the Greek stadiums. There's the rock. Three-story press box. And look at all this seating. We're at Assembly Hall, where they shoot hoops. Here's a slightly different view. This is the field house, where they run track. The Musical Arts Center has this enormous sculpture on the front lawn. The Stella here is ready to play some tunes. Hoagy Carmichael.